मत कर आगे। आइए आइए।
एक सौ आठ नंबर भैया।
Say hi to my new friend, the double hump camel. Sound only in this region, in India. They've got a double hump. They're quite docile, actually. Right? We spent a night here at this cozy homestay, and now from here we're going to Pangong Lake. And then back to Leh. Today's distance is going to be about 350 kilometers, so it's not less. It's all mountainous region, but yeah, I think we'll be able to manage just fine. Tomorrow we leave Leh and we start moving towards Srinagar. This is day number 15 and this is Rohan signing in from Hundar in Nubra Valley. Today's distance is going to be roughly 350 kilometers because we'll be riding from Hundar to Pangong Lake and then from there back to Leh. So all mountainous region, we're all ready, luggage is all set. We had a nice stay in this beautiful homestay for the night. The bike is nicely warmed up now. Oh, weather is nice and clear, but Pangong Lake is going to be quite cold. That's what people are saying. So we'll see how it goes. This is a proper village. Hundar is a small village. It's really nice. I've never stayed in such a village before. It was a good experience. Time to go. Here we go. Definitely, although we are in Nubra Valley, it's still quite high up. So, if you do anything exerting, you tend to pant a little more. Quite a heavy bike. Okay, none.
Oh, that medicine.
Chalo.
Money got to know who is he.
Hassan.
Oh.
Hi.
In Karnataka, nobody is like Karnataka, Bangalore, RCB.
Okay, we're all set. Bye, guest house. Now in the morning, I'll be able to show you how this village is. Lots of guest houses in this area. Moria. क्या गिर गया?
पहले तो ये निकाल रही थी, नीचे गिर गया।
This is the main road of the town. It connects to all the homestays and the hotels in this area. We'll be stopping for some breakfast. Now we'll be hitting the highway shortly. It's right there. and you get a good view of the sand dunes from the highway. Altitude 3150 meters. So even though we are inside the valley, it's still 3150 meters. That's crazy. Ready to see samosas? It's not open. Huh? Everything closes very early out here. 8:30, and feels like nobody stays in the town. Everybody goes back home. So, in fact, they start to shut as early as 5 o'clock in the evening. Yesterday, we had a tough time finding food. We had coffee at that coffee shop yesterday. And Diskit is 7 kilometers from here, Diskit Monastery. And now Hundar was there. You see all those green trees? That's Hundar. And this is the mountain range. I'll show you the sand dunes on the left side. It'll come up in 2 minutes. And off we go. Look at these mountains. What are these slopes? It's incredible. Incredible India. Apart from the ECU failure message, which has to do with the headlight, the bike has performed very well so far. Those are sand dunes. There, beautiful sand dunes. So we did camel riding, double hump camel riding over here last evening. It was a surreal experience, camel riding by the sunset on a desert landscape. Wow, it was just out of this world. So we'll go to Diskit and have some breakfast now. Look at these amazing sand dunes. Wow, yeah. It's a cold desert, Ladakh. That's why sand dunes and freezing cold. Look at these slopes. Okay, let's get going. It's 8:45 in the morning. Amazing, no? Very picturesque town, very picturesque. That was close. It's best to honk. Although I don't like honking. But what to do? Sometimes you have to. That's the entrance to the Diskit Monastery. We had been there yesterday. Look at Nubra Valley. Beautiful region this is. Nubra Valley. I really enjoyed my stay over here. And it's time to go back to Leh. But before that, Pangong. Whoa. Very steep turn that was. Never seen anything like it. For everything here. They are frightening, they're majestic, they're surreal, the mountains. You see how that snow-capped mountain is just peeking out now? I couldn't see it 2 minutes ago and now just look at that mountain. I don't know if the GoPro can capture it, but it's there. It's huge and it's full of snow on top. Look at the color. Let's go. There's a petrol pump coming up on the left side. Here it is, Indian Oil. We'll be filling up over here. Nubra Valley filling station. Yesterday we came from here and went down, and today we are coming back up the same road. But we are not going to go here towards Khardungla. We are going to go straight from here towards Pangong Lake. There's so much of sand on the road. This road is not used a lot by people. So I guess that's why there's a lot more sand on the road. And as you can see, this is a heavy landslide area. Shouldn't wait here. And one more way of analyzing that this road is not very widely used is the lack of plastic bottles on the road. It feels so good to not see plastic at the side of the road. That's Nubra Valley down there.
Looking for you.
Yeah, I'm here, right here.
This
road is absolutely untouched. There's not even a single plastic wrapper on the road. It's so good to see. And look at the view. Autumn colors. Beautiful. We're really exploring Ladakh in depth. This is not a usual route. We are taking a sort of back road to go towards Pangong Lake. More water crossing. You can see it's pristine, virgin piece of Ladakh. This is such an unusual route. We're going higher and higher up now. Today it is very cloudy. So if it gets too cloudy on the high altitude passes, then it could be a little bit of a problem. What a nice road, yeah. Beautiful. The weather is not looking so good up on the left side. This side is still alright, but overall there is a forecast today, so we could encounter some snow also. no civilization anywhere for miles away. No one's using this road. Taking the road less traveled. Feels good to know that. It sent you out of nowhere. Amazing. Untouched sand dunes, no people, just pure nature. To this crossroad, a T junction, you take a left to go to Pangong Lake. Pangong Lake over here. So we just crossed the river and now we are going towards Pangong Lake. Most scenic route of the trip so far. Blue color water. There. And I think there's water coming out of that cave, that's why there's some plantation also there. High up in the mountain. So guys, I have not saturated the image at all. This is actually the color of the water that is flowing. Shayok Valley on the left. Definitely snowing out there. Beautiful. The weather is very cloudy today. Supposed to do some entry over here. Yeah, entry. Shayok restaurant. It's not looking so good. It's 1:10 in the afternoon. It's very cloudy in front of us. We could encounter some snow. Descending altitude fast. Shooting stone area. Whenever I see beautiful landscape, I just want to quickly take a look. Wow. Just look at the color of the trees. Look at this canyon. Wow. weather is getting very unpredictable now. It is 1:30 in the afternoon and there are just heavy clouds everywhere. And some people were saying that it's going to get too cold at Pangong and then on the way back at Changla Pass. Now it's a dash towards Pangong Lake, click some photos and then just move out of this area because it's going to get cold. And mountain weather is anyway unpredictable, and that too in mid-October. A lot of crosswind right now, so the bike is moving quite a lot. Today is going to be one adventurous day, because from Hundar to Pangong Lake and then Leh back to Leh is quite a lot of distance to cover, especially in this kind of a terrain. But we'll do it. There's so much of wind. It's getting freezing cold now. Pangong Lake. We are at Pangong Lake. Finally made it. Yeah. I think there's only 2-3 drops of coolant that have come out. Nothing else.
No, that should be awful.
Nothing. Completely fine. Completely fine. Your bike is fine. It didn't start for 2-3 minutes. After that, it started. Yeah. So that man said come from here. This is the only way. Nothing is leaking. It was a very soft fall. Very soft, like gentle fall it was.
Cab driver said like Changla is too what to say?
Too cold.
Too cold, it's not even too cold, more than that. It's worse at some Changla.
So, we'll just wear whatever we have and make it.
Here we had planned to have lunch, right?
Yeah.
We will cross Changla and then we'll give a halt. From here, 40 plus 40 is Changla.
Definitely.
Because evening again, it will be like worse.
Come on, let's quickly go to the lake. This is the famous scooter and the three bums of three idiots. Okay. Nice. Of course, the famous blue and green colors of Pangong is not visible right now because of the cloudy weather. It is 4:30 in the evening. We are very late. We are at Durpuk just now. We are about to scale the mighty Changla Pass. It is not an easy pass. We have to brave not only the altitude but also now the rapidly changing weather. You can see that the weather is not so good right now. It is cold and it's going to get colder. Changla Pass. It's a very long pass, so you have to keep climbing for a long time. That's what I've heard. There are lots of these shortcuts, but I'm going to stay away from shortcuts. Because as tempting as they look, it's easy to take a fall on one of these. That's it. This is the second last pass of this journey. Changla Pass and then Zojila Pass on the way to Srinagar. Come on, baby. We were at 14,000 feet down there. Can you imagine? And we are gonna go even higher up. I could feel some snowflakes right now. It's definitely snowing up ahead. And if that is the route we are gonna take, then we'll definitely see some snow. Right now, I'm wearing all the layers that I have, and so is Mohini. So let's just quickly ask her how she's feeling. Are you feeling cold, Mohini?
No.
Okay, good. Keep your visor closed. Extreme temperatures, guys. It's not a joke. October, mid-October in Ladakh is seriously another experience altogether, because you are just braving the cold all the time. May, June, July is the best time to do Ladakh. October is not. It's 4:45 and one truck driver who was coming down this route said the weather is becoming really bad up ahead, so he has advised us to cover this road as soon as possible because the weather is getting really bad now. Yeah, I can see what he was saying. All the best, baby! Going in that direction. Definitely, I can feel a power loss now. We're very high up. And with Changla Pass, the thing is, you're at a high altitude for prolonged periods, you know. It's not like you quickly go up and then go down again. You're always at a high altitude. So I do feel a shortness of breath. Nothing that can't be managed so far. All the car people must be thinking we are crazy to be doing this on the bike, that too in the evening time, 5 o'clock, or 5:30 now. Oh, it's freezing cold. I'm feeling cold inside the winter gloves also. Very cold environment. Except for some trucks here and there, there are not too many people using this road right now. And anyway, in the car it is much, much easier. We have a heater and everything. But we, on the other hand, are exposed to the full environment, exposed to the elements. Oh, the road is also not that good here. And you see there's ice. Streams have become ice. That's how cold it is. I cannot describe to you how cold. I've never done this before. I've never ridden in such extreme temperatures before. Ouch! Come on! Oh no! The weather is looking more and more menacing in the direction in which we have to go. But we will do it! Oh man, it is easily -8 or -9 right now, easily. For a moment I thought, did I take the wrong road, because I can't see anybody. Obviously no one's going to be taking this road at this time of the day. But one reassurance is that there are plenty of tire marks. So I suppose we are going in the right direction. Oh man, we are going to feel snow any moment now. Shit, look at the weather ahead. Oh man, I'm a little scared now. Oh, finally we are getting to encounter snow. But trust me guys, it's not fun right now. It's quite scary. The roads are bad. It's starting to snow now. Oh boy, starting to snow. Scary, hate to say it, but it's an avalanche prone area and now there's snow on the road also. This is the first time I'm riding on snow. Oh, what a thrilling experience. Oh fuck, crazy. Come on, we have to reach Karu. Karu is the target. From Karu to Leh is quite easy. Karu is another 50 kilometers away. And oh boy, look at the view. It's awe-inspiring. Oh damn. And obviously none of the hotels are open right now. Snow on my tank bag. Can you believe that? Look at this place. Oh boy. We made it to the top of Changla Pass. This is the cafeteria. But that's the Changla Pass out there. But we are not waiting here because it's getting late. Plus it started to snow now. Puna. चल एक चक्कर मार के जाएंगे. नजदीक आए ऑल्टीट्यूड तो देख लेंगे ना. चांगला पास 17,688 फीट अबव सी लेवल. इट इज इनसेनली हाई राइट नाउ एंड इज बेस्ट वी कीप मूविंग फॉरवर्ड एंड गो टू अ लोअर रीजन. I have never experienced a more frightening weather in my life. But I think we have reached the summit of Changla. Now we are heading lower, lower and lower. Now we are heading lower. That was the summit of Changla. Thank you.